Всем привет! It's Mila from Hacky Russian, and I'm here to help you learn Russian language easy, fast, and with lots of fun. In this video, I will share with you the key rules to learn Russian cases. Russian cases. I know that it's a nightmare for people who want to learn Russian language. Nominative, genitive, dative, accusative, instrumental, and prepositional. All these six cases require different endings for nouns, pronouns, numerals, and adjectives. And in order to put the endings correctly, you need to know in which situations each of these cases is required. And here is an interesting fact. Russian natives don't know all these cases. I'm serious. We learn all these cases at school and then forget them. But as you may have guessed, we already can speak Russian before going to school. We learn how to put the endings correctly from the context without even knowing the names of these cases. And we discover them at school. So we discover that the way we put these endings is actually called declension. However, I may assure you that even Russian natives tend to make mistakes in some cases, especially when it comes to the genitive and accusative cases, which are often in competition. But what are the cases and why do we even need them in Russian language? In English and in many other languages, we have a direct word order. There is a subject, a verb, and an object. For example, I love you. I is a subject, love is a verb, and you is an object. Everything is clear because each word has its fixed place. And now let's look at the same sentence in the Russian language. Я люблю тебя. Or Я люблю вас. Я люблю тебя. Я люблю вас. Я is a subject. Люблю is a verb. And тебя or вас is an object. But we can also change the order of these words. The meaning will be the same, but the emphasis will be changed. You can really juggle the words in this sentence. For example, you can say Я тебя люблю. So we put the object right after the subject. Я тебя люблю. Я люблю тебя. No difference in meaning. However, you can change the emphasis of words in this sentence. For example, you can put the object in the beginning. You can say «Тебя я люблю» or «Тебя люблю я». We have the emphasis on the word «тебя» or «вас». «Вас тебя». «Вас я люблю», «Вас люблю я». So in this case, you really want to show that you love this person and not someone else. Тебя я люблю. Тебя люблю я. Or you can even put the verb in the beginning of this sentence. Люблю я тебя. Люблю тебя я. It's almost like a cry from the heart that you actually want to show a person that you really love him or her. Люблю тебя я. Люблю я тебя. That is why the declension of words is really important in Russian language. Each word serves a specific role, and if we don't use the declension, we will be lost. We will not understand what a person wants to say. So, if you want to speak Russian language, you have no choice but to learn Russian cases. But you need to learn Russian cases a smart way, because if you are learning Russian cases a traditional way, you may be stuck for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years without being able to speak properly. And here are the key rules to learn Russian cases a smart way.
Rule number one. Don't learn all cases at once.
You need to dedicate a substantial time to learning each case properly. And when I say properly, I mean all situations when a particular case is needed. Each case is a system, and if you don't know all situations when a particular case is applied, you don't see a whole picture that can actually help you to better understand when we use these cases. As a teacher, I found it really frustrating that I couldn't find one good book with full explanations for each case. That is why I decided to create my own guides for each case. Really comprehensive guides that cover all information for each case. And I am excited to tell you that I have recently received my first book on Russian cases. The most comprehensive guide to the Russian genitive case. This book is dedicated entirely to the Russian genitive case. As you can see, it's quite thick, and I assure you that I have included all situations when the Russian genitive case is needed. You can have a look at this book on my website. Find a link in the description. By using my guide to the Russian genitive case, I will prove you why learning all situations is really important. When you learn the situations and not simply the endings, you will understand that you don't even need to memorize these endings, because it's really possible that you already know how to use them. Because, for example, the genitive case is not only about the possession and ownership that we know. Yes, we know that the main function of the Russian genitive case is a possession. But there are some situations, many situations, when it goes beyond it. For example, you can wish something to a person using a genitive case. Отличного дня. Отличного дня. Or всего хорошего. Всего доброго. Спокойной ночи. Приятного аппетита. In all these situations, we are using a genitive case. Or you also need to use the Russian genitive case when you need to get somewhere and you want to ask the direction. For example, как добраться до ближайшего супермаркета? Как добраться до ближайшего супермаркета? You also need to use the Russian genitive case when you want to tell a person where you are from. For example, я из Америки. Or я из России. Америки, России. These words are in the genitive case. Or, for example, you are lost in the city and you're calling your friend to explain where you are. Again, you will need to use the Russian genitive case. For example, я стою возле театра, недалеко от парка, напротив кинотеатра. And so on. It depends on your location. So this way you are killing two birds with the same stone. In Russian we say убить двух зайцев. Убить двух зайцев. So you're not simply memorizing the endings for each noun. For example, парк, парка, театр, театра, and so on. But you learn these phrases, these handy phrases that you will need in your speech. And when you learn all these different situations with all these different phrases that you can actually use in your speech, You don't even need to memorize the endings. You just need to use your deduction and your logic when you need to put another word in the genitive case. And to make it even more effective for you to remember all situations that require a particular Russian case, you can create a story with all these different situations. That is actually what I did for my guide to the Russian genitive case. I wrote a story about a man called Gena. Gena, genitive case. And this story includes all situations that require the genitive case.
Rule number 2. Learn Russian cases in context.
The context is really important when it comes to learning Russian cases. You cannot simply memorize the endings for each case. Yes, you can, but it will be really hard, and in addition, you will not be able to use them in your speech, because you need to learn these endings together with words within a sentence. For example, you can create some example sentences that will remind you of different endings for each case. These sentences can be funny and even hilarious. The most important is to make them memorable.
Rule number 3. Create your own system of practice.
After learning all different situations that require a particular Russian case, you need to create your system of practice. And by practice, I don't mean grammar tasks. I mean a real research. For example, when you read a blog post or you listen to a new Russian song, you need to actively search for the situations that you have already learned. And when you're trying to find these different situations, you need to keep in your mind different trigger words or prepositions that require a particular case. And what you can do next is to actually attribute a particular color to each Russian case. For example, nominative case will be blue, genitive case will be red, dative case will be green, accusative case will be yellow, instrumental case will be purple, and prepositional case will be brown. And when you read a new text, you need to highlight these words and their triggers in a particular color that you have attributed to this case. Believe me, it helps a lot to learn Russian cases, because it's not a simple memorization, but you actually need to analyze the text and you need to find these cases yourself. It's actually fun, really. And of course, try to find some easy and interesting texts on the topics that you like.
Rule number 4. Have fun.
I'm serious. When you're learning Russian cases, it's very important to have some fun, because otherwise you will be so bored and you will not want to continue learning these cases. Russian grammar is boring overall, but you can always find some really interesting activities that will make you interested in learning Russian cases. For example, Russian songs. Because you're not only boosting your vocabulary, but you're also learning Russian grammar and improve your pronunciation. If you don't like Russian songs, you can watch Russian movies. And again, you need to analyze each line and find Russian cases. And always try to use some phrases in practice. It doesn't matter whether you're using them to speak to someone or if you're using them just to speak to yourself. Every practice is great. You can even talk to your dog or to your cat by using different cases. Well, I hope that you enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, don't forget to like it and leave a comment below. Увидимся в следующий раз. Пока-пока! Thank you.